Before we do a specific gravity test, we need to prepare a sample. First of all, we need to sieve it through 2.36 millimeter sieve, shown here. We have done this before, and this is the soil that we will use for a specific gravity test. Next step, we need to rifle the soil to obtain a subsample, and we're going to use a rifle box, and we're going to pour sample in the rifle box. And then we have two subsamples, and we use one of them, and we're going to pour it in this bowl. After this, we can start our test. Thank you. We'll do specific gravity test. Specific gravity, it's very important value of soil that we get from a laboratory test. Specific gravity is related to the density of solids, or what we also call it density of solid particles. The way to get the density of solid particles, we need to know the mass of solids, which is very easy to get. We just dry soil and measure its mass. But it's very difficult to get the volume of solids because there is lots of air in the pore space created by solids, and we need to get rid of this air. To do that, we will do this test, which is called specific gravity test. To do the test, we need soil, and I already have it here prepared. For us, then we're going to use flask or water bottle. We will also use distilled water. The first step of this experiment is we're going to get 100 grams of dry soil. This bottle should be well cleaned and dry, completely dry. I'm going to put it on the scale. I'm going to use this funnel and set it to zero. I'm going to add 100 grams of the soil. Nice and easy. Nice and easy now. Okay, we want to make sure it's 100 grams. And we're going to write it down in the table. Mass of dry soil, M0 is 100 grams. Next step is we're going to add water, about 2/3 of the bottle. The point is to saturate the soil. We'll add more water. It should be about 2/3 of the bottle. Just add a little bit more. Okay, that's about right. Well, even though we pour some water in the bottle, it takes some time for soil to become fully saturated. So what we need to do next is we need to wait for 24 hours. I'm going to leave it here on the desk. And I will come back next day and continue the test. Hello again. This is the soil that we prepared yesterday. It's now saturated. And what we'll do next is we're going to put it inside this container, like this. And we're going to seal it. We're going to cover it with the lid and seal the whole container. And after that, we'll apply vacuum. We apply vacuum at about 13-15 kPa to suck the air out of the soil. And we will do this test for about 10 minutes. Well, it's been 10 minutes. Now we can stop a vacuum and we will take the bottle back. We're going to gently open the lid. Hopefully we got rid of all the air inside the soil. So what we do next is we're going to fill this flask with water all the way to this mark, and then take the weight of this flask to get water and soil. Or I can probably put it here. Okay, it's okay, that's about this much. Now we need to dry the neck of the bottle. And we'll take the measurements. So the mass of water bottle, soil, and water. It's 411 and 2. Okay. Next step is we're going to get rid of water and soil. We're gonna clean this flask again, and we're gonna fill it only with distilled water. And after that, we'll take the measurement, the mass of distilled water in this bottle. This is water bottle filled with distilled water. You see it's all the way to this mark. We're gonna get the mass of it. I'm gonna put it on the scale. And it gives us 349.9 grams. What we do next is we'll calculate the specific gravity, and we use this equation. I'll write it down in this paper. Specific gravity, it's mass of dry soil, which is 100 grams. Here we have 100 plus MA is 349.9 minus 411.6. Okay, so it's gonna give us 2.61, which is a very good value. Specific gravity of soil typically ranges from 2.6 to 2.8, depending on the minerals in it. And the final step, we will consider the correction factor. So correction factor, we'll look at the table. We'll see that for the temperature 23, the correction factor is 0.9993. And we will correct the specific gravity to 20 degrees of Celsius. We'll use the specific gravity 2.61 and multiply by the correction factor. And it should give us about 2.6. So 2.6, it has no units. That's going to be the answer. And this is the specific gravity for this soil. That concludes this experiment.